Ardito Cove restaurant is broiled flounder Florentine, char-grilled shrimp, amberjack, grouper, red snapper, blackened, broiled, or char-grilled, steak and lobster, prime rib, chicken, and so much more. Perdido Cove Restaurant is simply fine dining at affordable prices. 2.5 miles west of Dog Track Road at the Lillium Bridge.
Every day that passes, your old home movies grow closer to deterioration. Preserve those memories from the past for the family's next generation to see and enjoy. Have your home movies, photos, and slides transferred to video. Video Images specializes in this process. Unless you've stored those fragile films properly through the years, call now, before it's too late.
Hi, Phil Thomas Katt here, and welcome, my friends, to the Uncharted Zone. Here with me is Gulf Coast recording artist Ronnie Miller. How you doing, Ronnie?
Just fine, Phil. How you doing tonight?
I've never felt better, had less, or more, man.
Wouldn't it no good to complain, would it?
It certainly wouldn't. We're going to show one of Ronnie's videos now, and we'll be right back after this.
Backseat romance, holding you close and taking a chance. Those hot summer nights down at the drive-in, I wish we could love like we did back then. I wish we could love like we did back then. Just start all over and do it again. Bring back the feeling we thought wouldn't end. Oh, I wish we could love like we did back then. We let the thrill slip away. Remember how bad you'd want me to stay. When I take you home and the night had to end, I wish we could love like we did back then. We could love like we did back then. Just start all over and do it again. Bring back the feeling we thought wouldn't end. Oh, I wish we could love like we did back then.
Thomas Katt here, and we're back with the Uncharted Zone. That was I Wish We Could Love Like We Did Back Then. Great video, Ronnie. Where did that come from?
Don't that make you want to get up and dance, man?
Yes, it does.
That's a grinder song if I ever seen one.
Yes, it is. I noticed the footage there. You had some from the chicken box, and you had something out on the beach. It was really good. I liked it.
Yes, we did. It took me about 2 months to get that thing together, Phil. We went, and I got the antique car club members in town here to get together and help me out with that video, and I want to thank them if any of y'all are watching. For bringing, especially the old Corvette. That Stingray was bad to the bone in that, and I want to thank my friends for bringing that out there. That video was. I had written a song that I was gonna try to pitch to Ronnie Millsap a few years back, and I did a concert with Ronnie back in the '80s. It was a benefit for the Ronald McDonald House, and we I did that song. I gave him a tape of it. I never heard back from him, and as usual, I just went ahead and cut it myself, and shot the video on it. And the lighting on the video wasn't quite what we expected because it was recorded at nighttime. So I just released it locally here and went ahead and put it on my CD.
You know, I really can't understand why Ronnie didn't record that. He just must not have seen it.
Well, you know, I think a lot of songs, people like to go back to the 50s type songs. They're really good dance type songs, you know, like these songs you're hearing in the background right now. I mean, they're real good listening songs, and they bring back a lot of memories for the older folks. And, I mean, they like to get up, and a lot of love was started back in them days, you know.
Yes, it was.
Experience Hot Rock Sushi, the healthy alternative. Relax in our beautiful garden setting while you enjoy the best sushi ever. But wait, we're not just sushi. Mouth-watering steaks and seafood are grilled to perfection on a hot stone at your table. Or try our tantalizing Asian noodle dishes and exquisite daily specials. We feature organic produce and low-fat cooking, open for dinner 6 days a week and Monday through Friday for lunch. Located downtown on the corner of Chase and Tarragona, Hot Rock Sushi.
Now that we recorded not too long ago, it's called I Think I'd Hit Rock Bottom. Now I believe there's like a true story to this. Am I correct in that?
Yes, you are. That song's got a real good meaning. Did I woke
get out your handkerchiefs, folks?
Are you ready for this? I woke up in the middle of February about a year ago, and it was the coldest night of the year that year. And I woke up and I went to get me a drink of water, and my pots had froze up. And so I walked into the kitchen, I opened up the refrigerator, gonna get a drink of water. There was no water in there, so I got a thing that I do whenever everything's going wrong like that. I decide I go outside and I run around the golf course in Cantonment out there. And so what I did, I went outside and I got my sweater on and everything. It was about 28, 29 degrees, and I ran around the golf course, the Champion Golf Course out there, and wrote that song in about 10 minutes, and every bit of what I'm saying in that song is the truth, so you can take it to the bank. That's a true story on that song, people. I promise you.
That's blue collar music.
Definitely blue collar music. I hope y'all enjoy it. Get a copy of it if you see one.
Hey, Ronnie, how many albums have you done throughout your career?
Well, are you talking about back in the 70s when I did gospel and everything?
Yeah, why not?
Okay, well, I was.
That counts.
I did two gospel albums. I did one with a group called the Gulf Coast Quartet out of Mobile, Alabama back in 72. When I was a lot younger, and just played guitar on that. I didn't start singing until I was with the Southern Breeze Band back. We were together 12 years. We got together back in 79. I was the lead singer and lead guitarist for that band, and we released a couple of singles. They did real good, so we put out the album Dixie Rose, which we'll be hearing about at a later time. And then the band broke up. Everybody kind of went their separate ways, and I pursued a solo career, and that's where Writer's Cramp came to be. I had enough songs compiled together in my library as a writer to put out a couple of singles and then put out that CD Writer's Cramp as well.
Bottom.
Phil Thomas Katt here with Ronnie Miller, and we're talking about some of the stuff he's done from his Writer's Cramp CD. And there's a question that I've had, and I was just wondering, who taught you to play guitar, Ronnie?
When I was 12 years old, in 1969, my dad passed away, and I picked up the guitar. It was my mother's guitar, actually, and she played in church, and I used to go and sit on the back pew and listen to her for hours upon hours. And she was a writer also, but she wrote nothing but gospel. And I just admired her so much. And I used to sneak in her bedroom and get her guitar out from under the bed. And she'd go to town with the next door neighbors and stuff and her friends. And I'd get that guitar out, and I'd just start banging away at it. And one day she came home and caught me. And I thought I was going to get a whipping for sure, but instead of spanking me, she said, well, show me what you got. So I broke out that old K guitar and that old Alamo amp, and I played Bad Moon Rising and Proud Mary by, who did that song? CCR.
Yeah.
Creedence Clearwater, I'm sorry. And she ended up giving me that guitar. That was my first guitar, and it just went on from that. I started playing professionally when I was about 14, playing gospel music and stuff.
Well, that's great. That's a very interesting story. Now, how old were you actually on the day that you first picked up the guitar and you knew that you had to do it?
It was the summer of 1969. I was just turning 13. In June of 69, I was turning 13. I picked up the guitar and I had my first concert on my front porch with a sheet as my curtain. I charged 25 cents admission to get in, and I went and bought me a new set of guitar strings after that concert was over.
So you spent your profits.
I spent my profit, and I'm still doing the same today.
Now, blues, booze, and barbecue. Drop on by and pick a few. Help yourself to a rib or two. Cold draft beer and Brunswick stew. Red and blues and eat them greens. Fat beef, fat back, boogie woogie beans. Goes down good with the whiskey chew. Blues, booze, and barbecue. Blues, booze, and barbecue. Boogie.
Now, I heard a rumor to the effect, Ronnie, that you were a descendant of Robert E. Lee. What's the story on that?
Well, on my mother's side of the family, I found out just a few years ago, we traced our family tree back. We come from Creek Indians, the Eastern Creek Indians. Come to find out, Robert E. Lee was on the Oklahoma Roll, and he came down from the Oklahoma Trail. And my grandfather on my mother's side was like his second cousin, which would make me like his fourth cousin. And I'm just really proud, and that's the actual truth. We trace the family tree down and stuff, and that's where the song that they took Old Dixie Down came from. It kind of spun away from that as my tribute to the Confederate soldiers, and it just kind of went on and went on. Everybody liked it so much, I just decided to go ahead and put it out as a single and everything. So.
Now, that thing kind of snowballed for you, didn't it?
It really did. It was so controversial that, you know, controversy sells, especially in this town, and everybody, you know, they get on all the jukeboxes in town and stuff, and you actually played it on the radio for me, and y'all did Robert Michael Green did an interview with me over at WXBM a few years back on it, and he got about 100 calls on it, and it got a lot of airplay, but unfortunately it didn't chart. We didn't have the money to get it in the charts, So, but that was my tribute to the Confederate soldiers and in protest of them taking down the Confederate flag in Montgomery, because that's not really a racial issue or anything else. I think that that is part of history. I think it needs to remain there. And if all you folks from the South agree with me, you know, that's part of history. You can't change that. You know what I'm saying? So that's how it came to be. And when I wrote the song, I cried. And, you know, and it's my tribute to my cousin Robert E. Lee and my mother. I love her very much, and that goes out to all of the Lees on my mama's side and all my friends. I appreciate y'all requesting that song, too. Really do.
Question for you, Ronnie. Would you really dig having a hit song?
Man, I would dig to China for a hit song, Phil. You would too, you know.
Yes, I would.
And I tell you, I really applaud what y'all are doing here on Uncharted Zone, getting all the local songwriters / recording artists a chance to get on TV, started out on radio, and now you've done Snowball and got your own TV show. And I applaud y'all for that. And I and all my fellow songwriters in this town and on the Gulf Coast, really thank y'all for what y'all are doing for all of us. Really do. Really do. You're a good man.
Well, thank you, Ronnie. I appreciate that. Appreciate you being with us on the Uncharted Zone. Really do.
Thank you, Phil. I appreciate y'all having me here.
Keep in touch, my friends. Join us next time on the Uncharted Zone.